First of all, I want to thank everybody for being here, obviously. And I want to thank these two individuals here. Elizabeth Chilton. Elizabeth worked this track tirelessly along with Gus for many, many years, on again, off again. And it was a pleasure to get to work for them. And I can pretty much say, from my experience working for Gus and Elizabeth, that John Stout pretty much was here just about every time as well, along with his wife, Sandra. They're just staples of this racetrack, just part of the tradition that's here. And it's been an honor for me to get to honor these people. It's something that I've thought about and dreamed of for many, many years. In fact, Sandra and I had several conversations over the years about all the wonderful pictures that she took. She'd always bring up old history of old races, an old Rome County Raceway, an old Tater Farm Raceway, and the Sunbrite Track, and all these different tracks that I never heard of. And I just loved hearing those stories and things that she knew about it. And we actually talked in the tower. The old tower was sitting right here where this memorial is right now. And we talked about that. And when she passed away, I told myself when I heard that she had passed away that I was going to someday, some way, somehow, make this happen. And when I was asked to come up and join the staff here and be the race director, I thought, well, you know, this is the perfect time to make this happen, and I can't think of a better time to just roll them both together and honor both those fallen heroes that I call them from Wartburg Speedway, and that being Gus Chilton and Sandra Stout. Now, as I have researched the racetrack history over the last few weeks, I wish I had more time because there's a lot more information out there that obviously we don't have here. But if you've heard me talk in the last several weeks, it's just a tremendous amount of history that Sandra has recorded, not only with her photos, but with her write-ups in the Rome Reader and all different area newspapers. And I also discovered a few things along the way that I wasn't totally aware of. I was not aware that the racetrack had actually closed from 1971 all the way to 1984 when Keith Longmire and Wayne Smith opened it back up. They ran it for a few years and then Gus got it back again, and that was the time that I was fortunate enough to get to work with Gus and the Chiltons, and we just had a blast. I just remember it always being fun. I mean, I can remember the fights, maybe some of the controversy along the way. We probably remember that stuff even now, and we get all upset about it, but I promise you, I'm standing here right now, and I'm reflecting back 15 or 20 years ago. I can actually laugh at it. I can laugh about the fights and realize just how unimportant it all really was. But it's funny, and it's all good, solid memories that we will continue to carry. And my goal with this Hall of Fame and the memorial race is to just delve into that history this racetrack has, build on it for years. There's a lot of gaps, obviously, we need to fill, and I do need some help. So before we actually make the presentation, then we'll let you know that you can nominate somebody to be inducted into the Hall of Fame next year, because we'll do it again, regardless of whether I'm working at the track or what my role may be. I hope and pray that the track remains and that we can continue to honor the legend that is Wartburg Speedway, the legend that Gus Chilton built, and the legend that Sandra Stout recorded in the way of history throughout all these years. So, if you'd like to nominate someone, we've got some clipboards here with names on there. If you think somebody you would like deserves to be in the Hall of Fame, obviously, Gus and Sandra are the first two inductees. And you, maybe you're interested in being a part of the committee. I've already nominated a couple of people, and they have accepted. One of those is John Stout, one of those is Keith Longmire. They've both been involved in the track. I've talked to Wayne Smith about it as well. But if you have somebody that you would like to recommend, or maybe yourself, maybe you'd like to be a part of the committee. Basically, that just means maybe meeting once or twice a year and voting on who you think needs to be in the Hall of Fame for the next year and the next year and beyond that. And it would help procure sponsorships. I've had people offering labor. I've had people offering parts and stuff. We would like to someday. I don't know where it'll be or how it'll be, but obviously we're starting humbly here with some tents. It's a pretty good start, I think, but there is so much stuff out there that I think that we can actually have an actual physical Hall of Fame, and we can continue to build on the tradition that is Wartburg Speedway. So, without any further ado, I need my plaques.
And my scissors.
We'll do the ribbon cutting for the Hall of Fame momentarily. First of all, I'd like to present this Gus Chilton Memorial plaque dedicated in the memory of our founding father, Gus Chilton, born July 13, 1926, deceased March 1st, 2015, to Elizabeth Chilton. Everybody's smiling at you there, and everybody's flashing at you.
One more.
She ain't gonna let nobody get that. Big round of applause once again. This is next plaque, obviously dedicated in memory of Sandra Stout, born October 3rd of 1948, deceased June 2nd of 2011, on the 6th day of September of 2015, for all of her. And John told me this too when I went down and I went to her little museum back in the back of the house, that she was a very unique lady in that she pushed him to race more than the other way around. He would be lazy and say, I don't want to go, let's just hang out, have a cookout, let's just stay home tonight. And she'd be the one to encourage him, no, you don't have to work on that car, you get out there, I'll help you, do whatever you need to do, we're going to the race. So she's a great lady, and we miss her dearly, and I'd like to dedicate this to John Stout. The Hall of Fame, and then at that time, I'll two announcer guys, Aaron Harvey and Dustin Bonham, to unveil the logo of the Memorial Race and Hall of Fame. One, two, three.
Thank you for coming out, and thank you again for allowing us to be a part of this great occasion.
almost all the time.
Name it, you need any more truck?
They're sitting right there.
All aluminum bodies, 700 pounds lighter, they're here tonight. We'll be placing every class tonight with that new F-250. So if you want to get them, they're up on us. Whatever you want to do, they're sitting there.
Brad, thank you very much. Thank you, Keith Babcock, we really appreciate you guys. Thank you. Again, folks, feel free to hang out. Like I said, if you're here now, you obviously are invited to stay for the races later on. It will be just a little while. We wanted to have time for people to come up and, you know, hobnob with each other and look through all these pictures. There's a lot of you go through several times. But just come on up and enjoy that, and we'll get the racing program underway here in a couple hours. But enjoy the Hall of Fame. You need to go home and relax for a while. You're welcome to come back later and come on in and enjoy the races with us. And again, thank you. We really appreciate it.